Hey everyone, this is Raja, Enterprise Agile Coach from ProXL Consulting. Welcome to the Agile Scrum Training. In the first module, we are going to discuss about 7 reasons for Agile software development. There are so many ways of developing software. The most popular one, which is being followed currently by many companies, is called Waterfall Model or V Model, a modified version of Waterfall Model. In this traditional Waterfall Model, software is developed in a sequential manner. We start with requirements analysis, where we capture the requirements from the client. Once the complete set of requirements are captured, we move on to design phase, where the complete set of requirements have been completely designed. And after the design is over, we move on to coding, where the design is converted into various codes using different programming languages. After the coding is completed, we go to testing, where the entire programs are tested to check whether these programs are in line with the requirements. After the testing is completed, the software is delivered to the client. When it is delivered to the client, there could be some issues or hitches at the customer's place. If that happens, then the software enters into the maintenance phase. So the software developers will fix those problems which are being faced by the client, and then subsequently the software is getting maintained. So this is a typical sequential lifecycle model most of the software companies are following currently. And this is called waterfall model primarily because once all the requirements are completed and frozen, we don't allow any changes to the requirements when we enter into design. Same way, when you complete the design and move into coding, there cannot be any changes to the design. So primarily, the water only flows down. You cannot make the water flow up, so it has to fall down. So that is why it is called waterfall model. This model is being followed by many companies, as we discussed earlier. Let's try to understand a bit more deeper into this particular model. So it all starts with requirements analysis. The business analyst or the requirements analyst from the software organization sits with the client or the stakeholders or the end users, or all of them, understand all the requirements of the software product that is expected out of this. Once all the requirements have been understood, it is documented into something called business requirement specification or software requirement specification. So once the requirement specifications have been written, those documents are shown to the client and we expect the client to approve the documents. Once the documents are approved, the requirements are frozen, so to say, because that will be the basis for subsequent development. So we use that frozen requirements document as the basis for both planning as well as subsequent technical activities. So subsequently, we move on to design. The complete set of requirements have been converted into various designs, starting with architecture design, where you come up with the high-level architecture of the system. Once the architecture has been frozen and finalized, you move on to modular design. So you design various modules and then move down to unit design. So once you complete all the design, both high level and detailed, and we freeze the design. If possible, you have to show it back to the customer, get their approval. Otherwise, at least internally, the technical team will review, approve, and freeze the design. Once the design has been finalized and frozen, we move on to coding phase. In the coding phase, the programmers create various programs in line with the design. The programs are written in various programming languages, whichever has been selected. And once the complete set of programs have been coded, then we move on to testing phase. We also do the reviews of this particular program, and every individual programs have been tested, what we call as unit testing. Sometimes we also call this phase as coding and unit testing phase, cut phase. Once the cut phase is over, we move on to the full-fledged testing phase. Here, the testers will take over the code and they do a complete thorough testing. Every module is independently tested. Module to module is assembled and tested. And finally, the entire system is tested to see whether the system is working in line with the requirements which has been understood and analyzed from the client's place. So subsequently, after the testing, the software is delivered to the client. And if required, customer also does their acceptance testing. Time passes this way in this life cycle. We start this analysis phase, say sometime in January, January 2nd week. Then we keep on moving. Let's assume this is a 1 year project. And by somewhere middle of December, let's assume just before Christmas, we deliver the software to the client. So January, February timeframe, we do requirements, probably about March, April timeframe design, subsequent timeframe coding, and then testing and deliver to the customer. So the time passes this way in this traditional life cycle. What are the advantages of this life cycle? There are quite a few. Number one, it is very logical. So finalize the requirements and then go to design and then go to coding and then go to testing. Pretty logical sequence. So plan everything upfront, then do as per the plan and check whether everything goes as per the plan, and then keep on moving and finally deliver the product to the customer. So pretty logical steps.